if there is no benefit for me to use PADU, why should I put my data in PADU?
Hi, welcome to another episode of Taylor's Take. My name is Elyana, currently majoring in computer science. And today here with me, we have Prof. Jess, professor in cybersecurity here at Taylor's.
Thank you for having me, and it is an honor.
Today, we will be talking about cybersecurity, and we will be using the current hot topic, PADU, as a case study. So, Prof, everyone has been talking about it. Ong Kian Ming was talking about it. Kari was talking about it on his podcast.
Yeah.
PADU. Maybe you can explain what PADU is in simple terms and how it is trying to solve having a multiple platforms.
PADU is established to consolidate data that can be used for the purpose of economic planning. I think for the purpose of targeted subsidies, for instance, as a part of it. I think the intention is noble. I think no doubt about it. I think that with that, government has also created what they call it the Omnibus Act that will allow the government to tap various databases from different agencies in the country and to collect it and centralize it for a specific purpose. But I think the issues that has been roaring, I think, talk about is about the security of it. In my view, a much more difficult part to handle is not the technology issue, but to manage the trust of the public. So to me, that is the key success factors of PADU in itself. If the public do not trust the system, they will not cooperate. So this need to be managed properly by the government.
Yeah, I think you're definitely right in that sense, because that day I opened like my family group chat and my grand aunt was sending those, you know, WhatsApp chain messages saying how dangerous PADU is and how you shouldn't use it. So do you have advice to give to citizens like this who wants to use PADU but are also concerned with the problems that is currently surrounding it?
To me, to use PADU or not to use PADU, it depends on the purpose of doing it. If there is no benefit for me to use PADU, why should I put my data in PADU?
Yeah.
Because the principle of data privacy is we do not surrender our data freely to anyone. So anyone who are interacting with the PADU system or whatever system, not just PADU, first have to ask the question, is there any needs for you to be interacting with the system? For instance, let's say if you are a part of B40 or eligible to receive subsidies, for instance, targeted subsidies. Yes, there is a clear benefit for you to be part of it. Then, by all means, be part of it and provide legitimate data, whatever data that is needed.
When we centralize everything in a platform like PADU, isn't there a risk? Because it's basically like telling the hackers where to go next.
The risk of PADU by centralizing data into one place will attract hostile activities. My take is that then a much more stringent data regulation, a much more stringent data protection regime has to be enacted to ensure that the management of any centralized system has to be audited properly, since we're going to have a Cybersecurity Act. It's coming soon. I think the government is already doing...
Is that the same thing as the bill that is going to be tabled?
No, it's still a bill. They are trying to propose a bill.
Once
the bill is tabled in the parliament and agree upon it, then it becomes an act. So then the law will have to apply on them as well. So there's no exception to anybody.
How important is it for Malaysians to understand the significance of cybersecurity currently?
As all of us are exposed to digital technology, we ought to know, we shall know about cybersecurity. When we talk about cybersecurity, many people would think that this is technology issues. The apps, the protocols, the viruses, antiviruses, intrusion, anti-intrusion, firewalls and all that. But there is also dimensions beyond technology, which is, for instance, data privacy, or I call it personal privacy. We must make sure that our data are properly protected. The third is cyber safety. People rarely talk about it. Cyber safety means that any issues surrounding the digital technology that affects human being. For instance, it could be the issue of cyberbullying.
Yeah.
It could be the issues of scams.
So, Prof, thank you so much for coming today. I learned a lot from you, and we also touched upon a few case studies such as PADU, the hot topic right now. So thank you so much for that. And that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned for the next episode of Taylor's Take.